Hey guys, welcome back to Adventure Camp and Tactical Nut here, and today we're going to be talking about the Clyde Challenor Custom MK2 Fixed Blade, so stay tuned. Alright ladies and gentlemen, let's run down the specs of the knife so I can roll into why I have enjoyed this knife so much and why I think you would enjoy it as well. You have a blade that is 7 inches overall, a 3 inch blade leaving you a 4 inch handle, G10 handle scales with torque screws so that they can be changed. You have black liners, and of course as you can see here you have 2 different types of jimping along the spine. About an eighth of an inch thick and M390 steel, and of course his logo right there. I think it weighs about 2.5 to 3 ounces. My scale is not 100% accurate, it's a spring scale, but it does seem to be about in that range. It is hollow ground, freehand, post heat treat. And I asked about that because Clyde does that because he says that it does keep a more consistent Rockwell hardness throughout the blade. So I would believe it, because I tell you what, the edge retention on this has been absolutely amazing. The contouring along the handles, as you can see here, absolute perfection all around. As far as in the hand, absolutely amazing feel, no hot spots whatsoever. And now I've never had a knife that had 2 different types of jimping along the spine, and I have to say that that really locks the thumb in there, but it's not aggressive enough to where it actually digs into the finger or hurts the thumb at all. And I gotta tell you, I've used M390 only on one other occasion in a knife, and that is when I got to review Clyde's Raptor. My friend Steve had sent it to me. Hopefully you've seen that video. If not, I'll leave a link down below, where I actually got to break one of the folding knives that he produces. And I mean, that blade was so amazing, I knew I had to get my hands on one of his. So as you can see here, scalpel precision in the tip, scalpel sharp. I mean, this thing came so razor sharp, it was almost scary. And I actually did cut myself with it the very first day that I had it, so beware of his edges, because if you're not careful, they'll bite you. Now, did come with a leather sheath. As you can see here, it does have his logo stamped on it there. This is for scout carry style, and I'll tell you what, I carried it that way and I absolutely love it. I carry it in the front of my belt where the buckle is, and it's absolutely perfect spot for it. The sheath retention, you can hear by that, excellent sheath retention, craftsmanship even on the sheath. And this is not even his specialty, but it has been absolutely flawless. Now, how did I get to come into owning this knife? Well, I was going to Blade Show and I was going to get a chance to meet Clyde in person for the first time, along with some of his team. And he wasn't going to be bringing any fixed blades, he was only bringing folders. So out of my disappointment for that, Francois, another member of the team, was amazingly kind enough to sell me his. And I can't say how thankful I am for that, because this has been an absolute joy to use. And I'll tell you what, it's never going to leave my collection, ever. And it gets used, I'll tell you that, it gets used. For an EDC knife, this is absolutely spectacular. Anything around the house you need to do, food prep, cutting up boxes, cutting open packages, that kind of thing, cutting rope, anything that you need like that, all of your small, lighter duty tasks, flawless. I mean, there's just no small tasks that this one just can't seem to do. Now, I'm an outdoorsman, so I use all of my knives out in the woods, and this one is no different. Feather sticking, incredible. Carving would blow your mind. Now this would not be used for processing firewood, just because it's a 3-inch blade, and most of the firewood that you would really need, you're going to want a larger blade or an axe. But what I'll show you here is what I've been using. This technique right here is called the tri-stick. It's a new protocol that I'm using for testing out blades, and it helps you test every part of the blade. And I have to say that this one passed every one of them with flying colors. I had the stick itself, but apparently Tactical Pup got a hold of it before I could do this review. But I do believe I have some pictures of it, so I'll try to roll those in at the end of the video. But ladies and gentlemen, this has been amazing. Now, what I will say, the M390 steel, it is a powdered steel. The Rockwell hardness is really high. I can't remember exactly what the Rockwell was. I'm thinking close to 64, if I'm not mistaken. But when I was looking it up the first time, it said that it was listed as difficult to resharpen, but I strop my knives, and so I'm telling you, if you strop your knives, you're very rarely gonna have to sharpen anyway, but literally all I've had to do with this is strop it on a rare occasion, and I think I've run it on a ceramic rod once, maybe twice at most. And so edge retention would blow your mind. I mean, especially if you're the type of person that doesn't like sharpening knives, this is the type of steel that you want. When people ask, why do people buy high-end steels? Edge retention is one of the main key factors. Because I myself, I don't mind sharpening knives. I even find it kind of relaxing to do it. But if I don't have to, even better. So, I think this weighs in, I can't remember if I said it already, between 2.5-3 ounces. And so when carrying it, you don't notice it if you just put this in the sheath in a cargo pocket. I've done that before, in a back pocket. And then of course on the belt, I mean, you almost can't even really feel that it's there. So highly functional, joy to use. I mean, just amazing piece of functional art. And one of the main reasons why I wanted to get one of his knives for myself to own forever, it's because I've gotten to know him, Clyde, over a period of time, as well as the other guys in his team. We're all in a chat group together. We talk every day. And I have to say, Clyde and his whole group are just good people. They're out of South Africa and they do amazing work together. And I gotta say that part of my philosophy of who I'm gonna buy knives from, your major production companies are just that. They're amazing, you know, major production companies. But when it comes to handmade knives, I like to make sure that the person that I'm buying from is actually a good person. And Clyde and his team all fit the bill. And so I highly recommend checking them out. I myself am now, since I test all my knives as they come when I get them, I am now, and I never do this, so this will tell you how much I love this knife. I'm actually going to order some different type of scale material and have a buddy of mine, Steve Condor, who's the one that introduced me to Clyde and his knives. He said he will make some different types of scales for me of my choosing. So this will be customized now to my liking as soon as I order the new scales. Not that I don't like these, but I just want something that, I don't know, a little more meat, I guess you could say. All right, guys, hopefully this will help you in your purchasing decisions of finding a incredible custom knife maker that just makes some of the best knives in the world. I mean, these things are incredible. He does a lot of work with folders. I do believe that is his preferred type of blade to make, and I highly recommend those. They definitely cost a bit more than these, but I would say 100% they are worth it. I've got to handle multiple ones and every one I just wish I could own as soon as I touched it. So, all right, guys, just one more look before I let you go of the highly recommended Clyde Challenor MK2 fixed blade. All right, guys, in the meantime, be prepared. Have fun and check out Clyde Challenor Customs.